Well, good evening, everybody. Happy Tuesday. It is a happy Tuesday. It's a great, glorious Tuesday.
Amen.
We got a chance. Some of us refreshed from the weekend. Others of us will be refreshed later. It's good. A chance to worship this lovely Tuesday. What a great opportunity to worship even Sunday. So many songs impactful. And continuing to reflect on the season of Lent as we proclaim the truth and our need for Jesus in our lives. Thank you so many of you who shared this last week. I see a nice uptick on that. So if you're back joining us, thanks. Feel free to make a comment, play a note. But what a joy it is to be able to share through song the truth of who Christ is in our lives and who he is for you. So we have some songs. I pulled some oldies out of the, I dusted them off out of the songbook. We're talking about praise. There's so many psalms. I don't know if you caught all the different psalms that we sung through as well as spoke of. This week we have Psalm 145, and it'll be what Pastor Scott will speak on. But the song Come and See, Psalm 66. Last week we sung Psalm 34, Come Taste and See. And this week, All Creatures of Our God and King is a reflection of Psalm 145. That's what we're doing. So I correct myself. Psalm 148, I believe, is where Scott is speaking. Either way, you're going to get one of them. It'll be fine. An opportunity to see what God says in his word. And so many of these psalms and songs tonight reflect on our praise to him, who he calls us to be, and our posture. So that's what we will do tonight. We have a call to worship based in Isaiah and John. And then we start in our praise. A couple songs mindful of this Sunday, which is our family Sunday. And so I'm hoping our kids really get into this first one. It's an oldie from Lincoln Brewster. Oh, I hear Greg. He's got it going. Then we're pulling out another old school song from Tommy Walker. That's why we praise him. Another praise-focused song. And that'll lead into another one that no matter your positives or your negatives in life, your joys or your sorrows, that will lift him high, will bless his name. And then that'll lead us into some scripture and some more music and gratitude and being able to praise him with the breath in our lungs. What a joy. So many good stuff. And then we'll end with a good praise doxology. Sound good?
Amen.
You with me on that, Terry? Mm-hmm. Fantastic. You with me, Greg? How you doing?
Yo.
Refreshed?
We're ready.
You look like you got a little bit of a beach sun going on.
Well, you know what? It was overcast, but, you know,
the moon. The UV still comes through.
It's a full moon.
There you go. Oh, watch out. And Mark, you look refreshed, too. We got our percussion support here, so can't go wrong with that.
Amen.
There you go. Well, let's begin with our call to worship. Together. It says, let us worship God, for whom our souls thirst and our bodies long. Amen to that. Listen to me, and your soul will delight in the riches of fare. We have come to hear the word God has sent. God's word will not return empty, but will accomplish through us his holy purpose. Let us worship God in spirit and in truth. And then we will go out with joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and the hills will sing. The trees of the field will clap their hands. Amen to that.
Amen.
Also in all things, whether mountains or hills, trees or us, we worship. Let's pray together. O God, in creation, you fashion us in your image. In Christ, you reveal to us your love. Through the Holy Spirit, you welcome us into the fellowship of believers. So we bow in gratitude before you. And we constantly distort your image, but still you restore it. And we daily betray your love, but still you extend it. We often disrupt fellowship, but still you bless it. So come unto us at this time and in this place, O Lord, that your image in us might be revealed, your love for us returned, and our fellowship in Christ renewed. Amen. Amen. Liesl says, it's good to see you all again. Looking forward to this time together. Nice. Amen. All right. Let the praises ring, am I right?
Yes.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I put
will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who never late is working all things out. Working all things out. Yes, I will lift you. Of our God and King, lift up your voice and with us sing. Oh, praise Him. Alleluia. Thou burning sun with golden beam, thou silver moon with soft. We haven't played that one in so long.
No, we really haven't.
That's pretty.
What a joy to be able to worship through that song again. It's been
nice.
A couple of the songs we just went through, three out of the four of us played in February of 2008 in a worship set. So it's good to bring some songs back, but give it a few more years, Terry, and we get to start saying things like, remember 20 years ago when we played that song? It's as long ago as my salvation story goes. So that's good. Well, Psalm 145, to tie in with what we just experienced. I will exalt you, my God and King, the King. I will praise your name forever and ever. Every day I will praise you and extol your name forever and ever. Tell me if this reminds you of a song, Terry. Great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. His greatness no one can fathom. One generation will commend your works to another. They will tell of your mighty acts. They will speak of the glorious splendor of your majesty, and I will meditate on your wonderful works. They will tell of the power of your awesome works, and I will proclaim your great deeds. They will celebrate your abundant goodness and joyfully sing of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and compassionate, slow to anger and rich in love. The Lord is good to all. He has compassion on all he has made. All you have made will praise you, O Lord. Your saints will extol you. They will tell of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might, so that all men may know of your mighty acts and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures through all generations. The Lord is faithful to all his promises and loving toward all he has made. The Lord upholds all those who fall and lifts up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look to you, and you give them their food at the proper time. You open your hand and satisfy the desires of every living thing. The Lord is righteous in all his ways and loving towards all he has made. The Lord is near to all who call on him, to all who call on him in truth. He fulfills the desires of those who fear him. He hears their cry and saves them. The Lord watches over all who love him, but all the wicked he will destroy. My mouth will speak in praise of the Lord. Let every creature praise his holy name forever and ever. It's a little Ryan Pelton song in there, if you didn't catch it. Psalm 145, the J&B album back in the day. At that, a very interesting message there.
See it.
It'll show up maybe. Well, we continue to worship. This is another psalm, Psalm 66. Terry has sang it last week before. We sing it as our song of the week. I get to sing it this week, so you get to hear me sing it tonight. Terry will add some beautiful harmony though. You ready for it?
I'm ready.
Okay, so am I.
Come and see.
got nothing new. How could I express all my gratitude? I could sing these songs as I often do, but every song must end, and you never do. So I throw up my hands, praise you again and again, 'cause all that I have is a hallelujah, hallelujah. And
nothing else did.
more time.
Amen.
All my words.
Yeah, let's do it. Yeah. Sing it again. It's a joy. It's already 6:41. We're at the end. I even added a song. How fun. Remember that God's got this. He's got you. Even though you might not have the words, and even though you might be feeling down, remember God is who He is. Singing hallelujah, praise to the Lord is what that means, by the way. So not only do our songs all say praise, 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 but every time you hear an hallelujah or hallelujah, it also means praise to the Lord. Everything points right back to Him this week as we focus on that psalm that we will be reading, Psalm 148. And it starts off by saying praise Him. And that's what we get to do. And that's what the theme is. I don't know if you caught it, but I just gave you the answer. And we end with a doxology. You see that creation sings out, we sing out the blessings of who He is. And amen. A good way to end this time together. Let it be so. So be it. Amen. That's how that comes together. So we sing praise God from whom all blessings flow. Then we sing praise to the Lord, which is hallelujah. And we sing, let it be so. Amen. You guys ready for it?
We get another ride on the Matterhorn right here.
Yes, sir.
We get to go again.
Raise Him above.
lift up your hands. Yeah, and now you go down the hill on the.
Now woo-hoo! My energy's going. All right, I'm starting over. Okay. No, amen. Praise our Father as it was in the beginning and now and forever shall be. God is in control. Amen. That was from your mom out there, Yolanda. Hallelujah, says Liesl. Amen.
Amen.
And the weird comment that I can see but nobody else can was from YouTube. So there's that.
Yeah. It's okay. It's gone now.
Oh, thanks. Way to go. So those of you watching on YouTube, it's all good. And the rest of you, thanks for chiming in. I saw my mom chimed in. So your mom's watching. My mom's watching. Just got to get Terry's mom to watch.
Yeah.
Mark's mom to watch. God is good. Amen. What a joy it is to worship together. Thanks for worshiping with us. We had a little bit of a different system going, so hopefully it all sounded great, looked good. Our Mevo's back up and running. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Sweet. See you guys on Sunday. Next Tuesday. Amen. Amen.